this crazy zebra family, right? So we're going to sing about it together. I am somebody because I'm a zebra. Let's sing it. Maybe. Give us a minute. Sometimes things happen. And you know what? Sometimes there's gremlins in the computer. Did you know that? Yeah. Sometimes there's little things in the computer. It makes it say, don't work. All right. I tell you what. We're going to sit down for now. But if we can get it working later, we will. So I want you to have a seat. And it's time for us to have Mrs. Amy and Mrs. Smith come out and join us. Can you give them a big round of applause as they come on out?
Hi, everybody. Are we on? Hello? Can you hear me?
Yeah.
Sound, ladies, is our sound on? Boys and girls, I don't know if you can hear me, but listen up. Welcome to another exciting edition of Zebra Zone. Is our microphone working back there?
No.
Okay. Can you hear me?
Yeah.
All right. We're so glad you're here today.
Zebra Zone is the place where kids come to have fun and learn the big idea. You know, that thing that grows inside of us to help us change the world around us.
That's right.
Mm-hmm.
Totally.
They have lots of fun.
Well, you know, it's not just the kids that have fun at Zebra Zone. The teachers can have fun here too, you know.
Have you looked over at the teachers? Because I'm not sure that they look like they're having fun, but I'll ask them.
Okay.
Teachers, are you having fun?
See, they're having
see
some
my
fun.
Point? Exactly. Now, you better hold your ears. Are you ready? Kids, are you having fun?
Those kids are definitely having more fun.
Uh-huh.
You are right.
They are fun experts, right?
Yeah!
So fun experts, let's go ahead and reveal our big idea for the month. Drum roll, please. 3, 2, 1. Humility. Humility is
putting others first. By giving up what you think you deserve.
Exactly.
Good job. Boys and girls, I'm so sorry. Mrs. Smith, I apologize. It seems that somebody here at school was using a sock to clean up a big coffee spill outside the bathroom, and then they flushed the sock down the commode, and so now the drain is all clogged up, and I'm gonna have to go and check on it and make sure it's being taken care of. So, Mrs. Smith, you take over, and I'll be back just as soon as I can, okay?
Okay.
Okay.
Oh, lots of technical difficulties today. While Mrs. Amy solves the mystery of who might have used their sock, I need to help you learn about humility. Okay. Humility is putting others first by giving up what you think you deserve. Putting others first by giving up what you think you deserve. I have an idea. You people right here, you have the best seats in the house. You get to see this wonderful face right up close. But you people in the back, I mean, I really feel sorry for you. You can't even see how beautiful I am from so far back. So here's what we're gonna do. On the count of three, we're gonna have this group stand up and that group stand up, and we're going to switch places. Okay, 1, 2.
Yeah.
not just about where you sit, but like how tall you are. Because if you have a really tall person in front of you, you can't see. So we're gonna need to line up by height. Probably most everybody, you know, so that's pretty good. Raise your hand if you had a birthday, if you have a birthday in April or May. Okay, now you guys, well, you're pretty lucky because you have a fun celebration that you either just had or you have one coming up. There are some of us that have to wait all the way till like November. And well, really, we don't have much to laugh about for months and months and months. So I think to be really fair, we should line up in order of height and by birthdays, and so in just a few minutes, I'm gonna have you line up. Mrs. Amy?
Mrs. Smith, what are you doing?
We were working on humility.
Do you see how much havoc you're creating out there? Probably making these teachers lose their minds.
Well, but it's kind of fun for us. I mean, whatever, they're sitting down here. We get to sit up here and watch it all.
No. Everybody stay right where you're supposed to be and listen up. This day is not going anything like I imagined it. First, there was that whole problem with the plumbing and the drains got all clogged. And we finally got that taken care of. And now,
oh.
Oh. Oh. I guess this is the sock that.
I guess someone was trying to, you know, show humility by using their sock to put others first and clean up the spill.
Is there something you would like to share with us, Mrs. Smith?
Yeah. That socks are a lot more absorbent than I thought they were. That is all.
That is all. I think there's more to this story. We need to talk.
Humility. Now to play this game, I'm going to need four volunteers from the audience. I'm going to need two teachers and two students to come up and help me out. But I can't get down there from that stage. I got a little crick in my back. So I brought today my very loyal and very handsome assistant, Mr. Fringles. Come on out. Pick two teachers and two students who are sitting on their bottoms nice and quiet. Take a good look. There's a lot of good candidates out there. Wow, this is the quietest this gym has ever been, I think. I'm impressed, boys and girls. Oh, I see one right there, Mr. Fringles. Right there. There's that teacher.
I think her name is Mrs. Wheel, maybe? Yeah. Come on up, Mrs. Wheel. We need a student, too. You got one, student? All right. Give Mrs. Wheel a hand. Right. We need just one more teacher and student, Mr. Fringle. I think I see one over here in the corner. Boy, he's really thinking about this. Let's give a round of applause to Mrs. Wortley and her student. Come on up. Let's take a look at these fine contestants coming up to our stage right now.
You're gonna come up now.
Let's find out. Now we know Mrs. Wheel. What's your name, sweetheart?
Addison.
Addison. Give a round of applause for Addison. And we know Mrs. Wortley over here. And who's your contestant?
Van.
Van. Give a round of applause for Van, boys and girls. All right. The game we are going to play today is called Humble Pie. And you can see on the table I have two very yummy pies. But what do you think? Can you ask me, what makes them humble, Mrs. Wortley?
What makes them humble?
I am so glad you asked. The humble part about it is we're going to have one contestant from each team is going to eat the pie, but they can't use their hands, folks. They are going to be fed their pie by the other contestant. Now, to bring in the humility part, one of those contestants is going to be blindfolded. So the person who's going to be eating the pie has to give up their beautiful face and get a little bit messy. Now, Mr. Fringle, who should get messy? Do you think we should get the teachers messy or the students messy? I think the teachers are going to get messy, Mr. Fringle. Now, I happen to know Mrs. Wheel and Mrs. Wortley are wonderful teachers. So I'm going to cover them up a little bit so they don't get too messy. So that they stay humble during the competition, I am giving them special coats to keep humbleness in their heart. And so they only think humble thoughts. I have special caps for them. And so that they only see humbleness, we have special little goggles for them. Do you want to help Mrs. Wortley out there? Can I get it? You. Help her out, Mr. Fringle.
I'll cut her.
Okay, what I need to happen, I want my teachers to come and have a seat at this table right here. Come on, Mrs. Wheel. Come have a seat.
You want here?
Sure.
Oh, that looks
good. And then Mr. Fringle is going to cover the eyes of our two student contestants. Come on over here with me. Now, you came with Mrs. Wortley, right? All right, so I'm going to put you next to Mrs. Wortley and just stand there for a minute. And you came with Mrs. Wheel, of course, so I'm going to stick you right next to Mrs. Wheel. Now, I like competitions, so what we are going to do is we're going to put 30 seconds on the clock, and the team that eats the most pie in 30 seconds is going to be our winners today, boys and girls. Can I have 30 seconds on the clock, please?
We can kick their booties.
Here you go. Oh, hurry up and go, boys and girls. Hurry up. Go, 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 go. Feed him, feed him, feed him. Come on. Whoa. Look at this boy go. Go, 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 go. Eat, eat, eat. Boy, Mrs. Wortley was really hungry today. Come on, Mrs. Wheel. I know you like that pie. Cheer on. Cheer on. Who do you want to win?
Come on! Oh, I lost my clock. Oh, I guess that was it. Mr. Fringle, come on over here. Let's decide who ate the most. Oh, Mrs. Wortley, what did you say about the pie?
It's delicious.
Oh, it does look delicious. What do you think, Mr. Fringle? Who's our big winners? Mr. Fringle says Mrs. Wheel.
And you guys might have to gear up today because this story flies so high, you just might have to fail. Now, I heard this story from my cousin's best friend, Wes, and it just about blew my mind. Which is why I'm protecting my brain box with this bad boy. Anyways, Wes likes to do tricks on his skateboard. He's like, I got steez, dude. And for you noobs out there, steez means style with ease. Wes has figured out all the tricks he can from the internet, and so he's begging his parents to go to this totally awesome, absolutely radical, totally tubular, 2-week skate camp in the summer that's hosted by this guy who competes in the X Games. And his best friend is Thor. But the camp costs kind of a lot of money, like a boatload. And Wes tells his parents he's been working so hard, and finally his dad says, okay, you can go. But just as long as it's the only extra thing Wes does all summer, because they don't have money for anything else. So, Wes's mom and sis Allie come back from the dentist, and mom tells him that the dentist says Allie needs braces now. And Wes is like, let me see. And then he has to resort to alternative measures. Dad says, we didn't think Allie would need braces, and now we have to save up for it. And then mom points out that if Allie waits too long to get braces, she's going to have to wear them a lot longer. Like 75 years? Dad says that's just an exaggeration, and then it won't hurt if they wait till next summer. And Allie bursts into tears and says, I'm never smiling again! And Wes feels like his whole world is spinning in circles around him because he has an idea. But he doesn't want to say it. And then he shouts it out. I won't go to skate camp! Whoa. Just like that. Wes says he'll go to skate camp next summer, and that way, Allie can get her braces right away. Even though he's kind of bummed about waiting a year to go to skate camp, Allie's smile makes it all worth it. And to celebrate, Wes does a double kickflip aerial with a triple twist. Ta-da! Don't try this at home, kids. Now remember, humility is putting others first by giving up what you think you deserve. Now, who knew these things actually worked? Later, dudes.
All right, boys and girls. Oh, here we go. That's a secret. But guess what? Did you know that we have somebody new in Rochester? We do, and we got a phone call. And Mr. Snyder says, Mrs. Beale, we've got to put this as part of Zebra Zone. So even though we're talking about humility, we wanted to introduce you to the newest member of Rochester. Are you ready? I want you to watch this video clip, and then you're going to get to meet him after the video.
My name is McGruff, and I'm the crime dog. I don't just fight crime, I take a bite out of crime. I also scratch fleas. Not really. I just threw that in to see if you were paying attention. Hi, I'm McGruff. I'm a pretender. I try to stop things before they happen. This is where my office is. You knew that, because you can read.
McGruff?
That's me. Most people don't recognize me without my coat on. Her name was Miss Tyree, and her daughter Samantha Tyree was acting strange.
Well, Sammy, Samantha, I don't know what's wrong. She's barely eating. She's crying a lot. And last night, she said she's quitting the ballet.
Quitting ballet seemed reasonable to me. I told Miss Tyree I'd see what I could do. I started my investigation at the playground to see if my nephew Scruff had any idea what was going on with Samantha. I explained the situation to him.
Oh man, I think I might know what happened.
I nodded to indicate I was listening and he should continue.
Last week in ballet, two girls were bullying her.
Oh, did you help her out?
No, I was scared they'd pick on me too.
He hadn't stood up for his community.
What's my community?
Your community is the world around you. Your neighborhood, your friends. And if you want it to be a nice place, then you have to step up and help stop bullying.
I didn't know what to do.
It's okay to be afraid, but it's easier to help than you think. Just be a friend. Stand up, go over to her, and together you can pirouette out of trouble.
Can we just walk away?
I nodded again, but this time it meant our conversation was over. I left hoping that the next time Scruff sees bullying in progress, he'll show his community a little more respect. Sammy, this is McGruff the crime dog.
Am I in trouble?
Depends. You steal my socks out of the dryer last week?
No.
I didn't think so. May I come in? Sammy, I'm here to find out what's bothering you.
Nothing really.
I detected 15 ballet posters. Like I said, detecting is part of my job. Boy, you must really love ballet.
I have to quit. I'm too fat to wear a leotard. All the girls say so.
All the girls?
Mindy and Bernita, they say so.
Bully!
I thought they were my friends, but they said having to look at all my fat was making them sick.
Well, that's not very friendly. It's not true. What you gotta do is stop, talk, and walk.
Stop, talk, and walk?
That's right. It's about self-respect, Sammy. You've gotta let the bullies know you're not gonna let them bother you. Respect yourself. First, stop listening to the bullies.
How?
Keep it simple. Ignore them. Shrug your shoulders. Look them in the eye. Then, talk.
But what do I say?
You can say anything. Make a joke. Say you don't believe what they're saying. Tell them you got someplace to be. Whatever.
Then I just walk away?
Stop, talk, and walk. That's how you show yourself some respect and put a stop to bullying.
Well, I'll try.
There we go.
Get it? She's speaking whale because you're fat.
Stop.
What?
Roasted carrots.
Hi, Sammy. Want to stretch somewhere else?
Thanks. I was just about to walk. Let's go.
And so Samantha and Scruff made the right choice. I hope you'll take the lessons you learned today and...
Who are you talking to? Are you for real?
Lessons are lame.
You're never going to make friends with that attitude.
We're friends.
Oh! Nice coordination.
I hate you.
I hate you too.
You see, that's the point. You won't have real friends if you only see the bad things about people.
What do you mean? I see all sorts of things about people. You're a computer nerd, and you, mister, are so 1980.
These kids are so observant. The whole truth is that people are different in some goofy ways and in some great ways.
Like how Mindy has a big nose, but is a fast runner?
I'm aerodynamic.
Well, that's the right idea. It might take some practice to see the good stuff about people, but you can do it. Well, until next time, I'm McGruff the Crime Dog, and I'll always be here to help you take a bite out of crime.
Hi, everybody. How are you guys doing today? Good. I'm Sheriff Sailors, and I've got a special guest with me today. Would everybody like to see him?
Yeah!
Okay, here's what I need you to do. I need you to all chant McGruff. 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 Louder. How you doing today, McGruff? Good? See all these kids out here? They're learning an important lesson today about bullying. They just watched a video about you talking about that. Did you guys follow that?
Yeah.
That bullying's bad?
Yeah.
That you don't make fun of people?
Yeah.
Okay. What do you think about bullying, McGruff? It's bad, isn't it? Yeah, yeah. So, a lot of these kids probably never seen you before, have they? McGruff's been around forever. Some of the parents in here, some of the teachers probably remember McGruff from back, if you caught that at the end, back in the 80s, kids. That's when he was around, so. Okay. You guys learning a lot today? Good. So, McGruff is here. Like I said, we wanted to talk about bullying. You saw the video about it. And McGruff's your friend, just like a police officer's your friend, okay? If you have a problem, you can come and find a police officer, okay? What do you think about that, McGruff? So, and we hope to have McGruff around a lot more. If you guys have more complications, we'll bring him here, so, okay? So you guys like McGruff? Do you know what McGruff says? You need to all repeat this, okay? Take a bite out of crime. All right. How's that, McGruff? Will that work? All right. Thank you. You guys have a good day.
Are we on? Yeah, thank you so much for coming. We are so excited to have you visit us today. Boys and girls, I have a special treat for you now. We had our reading challenge, Whoop It Up for Books, and you guys did a great job. You were fantastic. And we got to have a hula hoop reward time where you had a lot of fun showing me your hula hoop moves. But I promised a special treat for the classes that met their goal first. And so we're gonna do that today. I do wanna give you numbers though. For kindergartners who were learning sight words, their goal was to learn 1,200 sight words, and they went over that. Let's give the kindergartners a hand for 1,368. Great job. How about first graders? First graders, they said they could read 2,100 books, but guess what? They didn't do that. They read 2,866 books. Great job. You guys are awesome. I'm so proud of your hard work. And what about those second graders? Oh, let's hear what their goal was. Second graders thought that they could get 2,800 reading counts points. Wow, that's a lot. I'm happy to say they made it to 3,480 points. Great job. Columbia, you are fantastic, and I know you're going to grow up to be the best readers in the world. Today we have some special guests. In kindergarten, the first class to reach their goal was Mrs. Schrock's class, but she's not here today. So we're gonna have Mrs. Van Cleve and Mrs. Brady. In first grade, we're gonna have Mrs. Wheel and Mrs. Conrad. And for second grade, Mrs. Malco and Mrs. Thayer, because their class reached their goal first. So they're gonna come out and hula hoop for us and show us their moves. But I have one more surprise for you. We have a special guest with us because when it was his class's turn to have their reward day, he couldn't join in the fun. Matthias Jackson had a concussion and we all felt so bad because that means you have to sit and be quiet when you're watching everybody else have fun. And he really missed out on that. So he's gonna show us his hula moves today because he's better and back to normal and we're so glad. So he will be our special guest out here today too. So we're gonna have some great music. Mrs. Malko and Mrs. Thayer, I hope they're back here and ready to come out and hula hoop. Are you ladies ready?
Hi, Agnes. Hey, Edith, how are you?
Mrs. Malko. What?
Agnes, I'm so glad we tricked that Mrs. Malko, Mrs. Thayer into going to that meeting.
Now we can run the hole. Let's roll.
Agnes, look at this sign. It says hula hoop contest. Who threw the hoop? No, hula hoop.
Hey, are you guys someone's grandma?
That didn't sound like Mrs. Malko and Mrs.
You have red hair.
Who in the world is here?
Somebody help Mom up the stairs.
Would you like to come on out? Come and join us. Oh, okay. We're glad to have you at Columbia. Oh my. Matthias, lead them on out there and show them where they can hula hoop, okay? I think they're new to our school. Oh my. You're sure Mrs. Malko and Mrs. Thayer couldn't make it today? Wow. Well, let's enjoy the show.
girls, how fun was that? Show me those good listening skills, okay? We had a couple kiddos who got entered into the bucket probably yesterday or this morning that I did not get on announcement, so I want to quickly get those two or three in the bucket. Ellis Fidel made a free will donation to Strike Out Cancer Fund. Thank you, Ellis. So you're going to go in the bucket. We've got Sophie Beeler. She showed forgiveness by forgiving a friend who said mean things. Thank you, Sophie. You are also going in the bucket. And Riley Vessels earned 100 reading counts points. Impressive, Riley. All right, you're going in too. Okay, so this month we've been talking about forgiveness, but there are kids in here who have shown all kinds of great character, right, Zebby? Great stuff. So we're going to draw out 10 names. This month's reward is going to be a sidewalk chalk party. It's going to be beautiful on Monday, so you are each going to get your own sidewalk chalk, and we're going to go out and do some decorating on the front sidewalks. Does that sound good? All right. Go ahead and come up when you hear your name called. Pandora Bowens. Yeah, Pandora, good job. She did a great job during bus evacuations. We have got Riley Wolf. She had perfect attendance. Nice job, Riley. Our third student, Audrey Widman, passed all of her subtraction facts. And Riley Vessels earned 100 reading counts points. Next, we have got Emma Murphy. She was showing forgiveness. I think we need some boys, don't we? Let's see. I'm going to try for a boy. Andreas Hernandez, perfect attendance, third quarter. Bryce Trainer being great on the bus. All right, three more. Are you guys ready? Let's see. We got Jalen Dixon offered a friend to be in front of her at breakfast. How about Lexi Hawes? She's been doing a great job reading. One more for this month. Give me your attention. We have got Dylan Barnes. All right, you guys want to join me for some sidewalk chalk on Monday? All right, we're going to go out front and do some nice decorations. It's not going to rain, so it'll be a great day. Thank you guys so much for showing good character. Can we give all of these kiddos a big, big clap? Mrs. Garg forgot to bring the bucket of teacher names, but I have had a ton of teachers who have been showing great character this month, so I will do that drawing and announce them on Monday, okay? Give those teachers a big clap, too. Tell them thank you for being such good role models. They've been super hot and helpful this month. Okay. All right. Come back to you. No, you're just hanging out? they're going to come out this way. I guess. And tell everyone goodbye with us. Does that sound like a plan? We've had a fun Zebra Zone, but it's time for us to say goodbye. So I need you to stand up.